Welcome to Blackboard Basics for Faculty, a sabbatical project in collaboration with the Faculty Center for Student Success at Saddleback College. This is a 7-part video series, and today we will cover Part 6, Grade Center, Grading, and Viewing Assignments. These videos are specific to the South Orange County Community College District, but they are designed to help everyone using Blackboard. The Blackboard interface used in these videos is version 9.1. Interface design changes with certain updates, but many of the items covered in these videos have remained constant or been improved with each update. These videos are to help faculty who teach face-to-face classes use Blackboard to enhance their courses. If you are a student looking for Blackboard help, please see Blackboard Basics for Students linked below. Part 6, Grade Center, Grading and Viewing Assignments. In this video, we will cover 1. Organizing the Blackboard gradebook. 2. Grading Turnitin and Blackboard assignments. 3. Providing feedback to students in the Grade Center. 4. Creating new grade columns and hiding grade columns. 5. Instructor view versus student view of the Blackboard gradebook. Confession. I take a lot of classes, and I am always checking the gradebook to see how I am doing. The student view of the gradebook in Blackboard is very different than the instructor view. Students can only see their grades, but the layout is different than what the instructor sees. In this video, we will compare the two views. Number 1. Organizing the Blackboard gradebook. In your Blackboard shell, be sure the edit mode is on, and under Control Panel, click on Grade Center, and then Full Grade Center. Remember that students do not see any of the Control Panel items. This is what the Grade Center looks like with the assignments we created in Part 4 Assignments. The course has a list of students as enrollment opened, but I will hide them here and just show you my test student account. The Grade Center shows your students organized by last name, then first name. Then there are a series of columns. This is what the Grade Center looks like from the student view. Back in the instructor view, let's start organizing the grade columns. Sometimes students drop our classes, and when that happens, their name will stay in Blackboard, but show up with a gray circle and a line through it next to their name. To hide these students from your Grade Center, click Manage, Row Visibility. Click the box next to the name with the gray circle, and then click Hide Rows. Then click Submit. This will then hide the people who have dropped your class in the Grade Center. Now let's start organizing the grade columns. Click Manage, Column Organization. Here is the Column Organization section. Zooming in, we can see the last name and first name are visible and frozen. You can also view the last access, username, availability, and student ID. Here you can see I hide these items, and they are shown in italics with gray text to show they are not visible to the instructor. In the next section, you can see the other column in the Grade Center. They are weighted total, total, and the two assignments we created in Part 4 assignments. You can change the order of the columns in this view by clicking on the cross arrows and dragging them, or by clicking on the up-down arrows and arranging your columns that way. Once you have everything set the way you want it, click Submit. Now let's organize the assignments we have already created in Part 4 that link to the Grade Center because we created them in Blackboard. Click the pull-down arrow on the grade column you want to edit and click Edit Column Information. Number 1. Column Information. The item name is the name you gave your assignment in Blackboard when we created them in Part 4. This is the name that student sees in their view of My Grades. You can add a Grade Center name that will be the name you, the instructor, see in the Grade Center. In this case, I enter HW1. Under the description, you can write a description of your assignment. Students will be able to see this if they click on the link for the assignment in My Grades. I include a short description of the assignment. Primary display would be the grade to be displayed as score, letter, text, percentage, or complete, incomplete. I choose score. Now a quick note. It states under primary display that, quote, grades must be entered using the selected format. Grades display in format in both the grade center and my grades. The grade center is what instructors see when they view grades. This is the grade center. My grades is what students see. This is my grades. Back to the assignment we were editing in the grade center, you see our next option is secondary display. This option only shows up in the instructor view as it states, this display is shown in the grade center only. For this reason, I keep it as none. Score attempts using last graded attempt, highest grade, lowest grade, first graded attempt, average of graded attempts. I choose first graded attempt for this assignment. Category equals assignment. Possible points we already entered when we created the assignment. I am skipping associated rubrics for the basic series, but if you are interested in this, please visit the Faculty Center for Student Success if you work at Saddleback College, or reach out to other technology divisions in your institution for assistance. Dates, enter your due date. Options, include this column in grade center calculations equals yes. Show this column to students equals yes. Show statistics, average and median, is a personal preference, but I choose no in my courses. Submit, click submit. The only visual change we will see in the grade center, instructor view, is the name change of the assignment. Number 2, grading Turnitin and Blackboard assignments. Number 3, providing feedback to students in the grade center. To grade an assignment you created in Blackboard, you can click the pull-down arrow for the assignment and click Grade Attempts, or you can click the pull-down arrow next to the student submission and click Attempt to grade each person individually. I click Grade Attempts to grade all students, and this is the page I see. The student's assignment is here, and I can add comments on the student's paper with the comment button and add feedback that will show up in the student's My Grades here. I can enter the points earned and click this arrow to move to the next student and grade their assignment. When an assignment is graded, it will look like this in the grade center and look like this in My Grades for the student. For a student to see your comments, they need to expand the comment box in My Grades. And to see the comment on their paper, they need to click on the assignment link in My Grades, and that will open up their graded assignment. To grade Turnitin assignments, go to Control Panel, Course Tools, Turnitin Assignments. Click on your assignment link, and you will see the list of your students. Click the pencil icon under Grade to start grading your assignments. The assignment opens in a new window. Originality is where Turnitin shows you how much of the content might be plagiarized and gives you a link to the match. Grade Mark is where you can grade and give feedback to your students. One reason I use Turnitin is because of the options to save comments and reuse them. I can drag and drop comments that are universal and give individual feedback as well. You can enter the total number of points in the top right corner and then use the arrow to go to the next assignment. One thing I do not like about Turnitin is that it does not have a feature in this view that will leave a comment in My Grades for my students. I go in manually and add quick comment on these assignments to let them know to look in Turnitin to see my comments. As a student, I like to see feedback in My Grades, and as an instructor, I try to make sure to give feedback to each of my students. Even when a student earns a zero for not submitting an assignment, I let them know why. Number 4, creating new grade columns and hiding grade columns. Sometimes you need grade columns that are not part of an assignment or exam created in Blackboard for your face-to-face course. No problem. Just create a column in the Grade Center to enter points for your students. In the Grade Center, click Create Column, and a grade column will open for you. It looks like the grade columns we use for our assignments. Move through each of the fields and click Submit. You might need to reorder your Grade Center items, and you can do this under Manage, Column Organization. Then you can click in each box to enter a score for each student manually. Sometimes you might want to hide columns from students, and you can do that in the Grade Center. In this case, I will hide Weighted Total. In the Grade Center, click the pull-down arrow in the column name and click Show Hide to Users. In the Instructor Grade Center, the column shows up with the circle with the red line through it. In My Grades for the student, it doesn't show up at all. Number 5, Instructor View versus Student View of the Blackboard Gradebook. As we have seen in this video, the Instructor View and Student View of the Blackboard Gradebook are very different. The Instructor View can be set up for easy grading, and the Student View can be arranged in the order the instructor chooses. As a student, I always look at my grades and think this is a great place for instructors to keep grade information so students can view it securely. And at the end of the semester, instructors can use the Grade Center to calculate final grades. This completes Part 6, Grades, Grading and Viewing Assignments. In this video, we covered 1. Organizing the Blackboard Gradebook. 2. Creating new grade columns. 3. Grading Turnitin and Blackboard assignments. 4. Providing feedback to students. 5. Instructor View versus Student View of the Blackboard Gradebook. Our gradebook went from looking like this to this. Thank you so much for joining me for Blackboard Basics for Faculty, using Blackboard to enhance a face-to-face class. Leave any questions or comments below, and I will do my best to get back to you. Please join me for Part 7, where we will cover making your class visible to students and reusing what you created.